This current challenge is called rectangle area. We have to create two classes. The first one is called rectangle. It's going to have two member variables for the width and the height of the rectangle. And that is going to have a display function to print the width and the height of that rectangle. Then we're going to have a derived class. This here is the base class, so rectangle area is going to be the derived class. And it's going to have a function to read some inputs for the width and the height of the rectangle. And it's also going to have a display function which will print the area of the rectangle. When you start this challenge, you only have this preprocessor directive, and then you have using namespace std. And for the main function, we are creating an object that is an instance of this derived class rectangle area. And then we get the input for that object. And here we call the display function on that object, but we want to have the definition of that function from the rectangle class, that is the base class. Here we call the display function again, but this time we want to get the definition or the implementation from the derived class. So this here is where you have to write your code in between these locked sections. And I have the code already in Visual Studio. I have this include line because I want to add SStream. I'm going to use that to accept inputs for the width and the height of my rectangle. But let's start with this class here. That's the base class. So it's called rectangle. It has the member variables for the width and the height of the rectangle, and these are protected, meaning that these values are going to be accessible inside this class and inside the derived class at the bottom here. This here is the default constructor. It initializes both values to zero. And this here is the second constructor, which has parameters for the width and the height. And here I'm initializing the member variables. So the value of W gets assigned to the width, and the value of h here gets assigned to the height. Here, this is the display function or the display method. It only displays the width and the height on its own line, separated by a space. It does not return anything. That's why it's a void function, but it's also a virtual function because we have to override that method inside our derived class. If I scroll here, you see that we have another method with the same name, but it has a different implementation. So now we are done with this class here, the rectangle class. We can move to the derived class. It's called rectangle area. It is inheriting publicly from the rectangle class. And here it has a constructor. It doesn't initialize any values. But here we have this method, read inputs, and then we accept a full line of inputs using the getLine function. So don't use cin just on its own, otherwise you will only capture the width value and not the height value. Remember that the input looks like this. We have one value, then a space, and then a second value. If you use cin, you will only extract this value here. Once we have our full line of inputs containing the values for the width and the height, we can use this iStringStream object that I'm calling SS and pass it our user input value here. Using this SS object, we can extract each value as a token. So here I call SS, then I extract the first token for the width and I store it inside of the width member variable, and the second token will be assigned to the height. So here we have the display method. It has the same name as in the base class, but the implementation here is different. I have width times height, and this corresponds to the area of this rectangle. So let's grab this full code here for the main class and then also this derived class. I'm going to copy it and paste it. We have our first class here. We also have our second class here. Here I have a red line, like an arrow, because I need to scroll up here and include this SStream header. Normally in your program, you would add this right under IOStream, but here I have to add it under using namespace std because I cannot write any code inside this section here. So now that we have this, the red line is gone. I can run this code. We've passed the sample test case. Let's submit it. And we've passed all the 11 test cases. So that's it for this HackerRank challenge. It was called rectangle area. You guys can get the code for this challenge on my GitHub, which I will link to the description of this video. If you like my tutorial and my solution, please subscribe to my channel, and I'll catch you next time.